JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's Daily Market Review for October the 13th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, Head of Research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher or unchanged against most of the other major currencies on Tuesday during the Asian session Wednesday. It gained slightly against CHF, AUD and JPY, while it underperformed against CAD and GBP. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against NZD and the euro. Once again, the performance in the FX world paints a blurry picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, and thus we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, all but two of the major European indices finished their session in the red, with Wall Street sliding somewhat as well. Appetite improved during the Asian session today. China Shanghai Composite and South Korea's KOSPI traded in the green, while Hong Kong's Hang Seng was found virtually unchanged. Only Japan's Nikkei 225 was down. Now, although European and US equities slid less than on Monday, this still suggests that investors remain reluctant to increase their risk exposure, and with no fresh catalyst to drive the markets, we believe that their concerns are those we discussed yesterday, the day before, and even last week. Energy prices remain elevated, which heightens concerns over further acceleration in inflation and thereby faster tightening by major central banks. What's more, Evergrande missed a third round of bond payments in 3 weeks, which brings a potential default a step closer. Now, with inflation being the main driver for the markets recently, today participants are likely to lock their gaze on the US CPI data for September. Both the headline and core CPI rates are expected to have held steady at 5.3% and 4% respectively, well above the Fed's objective of 2%. Although the US employment report revealed a disappointing number of added jobs during the month of September, Fed officials remained willing to start scaling back their quantitative easing purchases soon, with yesterday remarks by Fed Vice Chair Richard Clarida, Atlanta Fed President Raphael Bostic, and St. Louis Fed President James Bullard endorsing a November move. Bullard even expressed a preference for interest rates to start rising in the spring or summer of 2022. So this encouraged investors to bring forth their rate hike bets. And according to the Fed Fund futures, they now fully price in a 25 basis points increase to be delivered in December next year. Remember that that yesterday such a move was priced in for January 2023. Now, this suggests that market participants don't need inflation to accelerate further in order to increase their tightening bets. Even staying unchanged and not pulling back may be enough, as this will add credence to their view that the surge in consumer prices may eventually not be as transitory as the Fed has initially expected. We may get more hints and clues as to how likely a November tapering may be from the minutes of the latest FOMC meeting, which come out later in the day. Therefore, anything cementing the November tapering case could prompt USD traders to add to their long positions and stock investors to reduce their exposure even more. Now, flying from the US to Australia, tonight during the Asian session Thursday, we get the nation's employment report for September. The unemployment rate is expected to have risen to 4.8% from 4.5%, While the net change in employment is anticipated to show that the economy has lost 137,500 jobs after losing 146,300 in August. At last week's gathering, the RBA kept all its policy settings unchanged, with officials repeating that they will continue to purchase government securities at the current pace, at least until mid-February, and maintaining the view that that interest rates are unlikely to rise before 2024. We believe that a soft employment report may add more credits to the RBA's dovish stance and may push the Aussie somewhat lower, especially against its Canadian counterpart, which has been enjoying decent gains recently due to the rally in energy prices. Friday's better than expected employment report may have also been a reason for a reason to buy loonies, as it increases the probability for further tapering by the Bank of Canada at its upcoming monetary policy gathering. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the monthly UK GDP for August, which accelerated slightly less than expected. However, industrial and manufacturing production rates came in better than their own forecasts. And but however, in any case, as we noted yesterday, the pound barely reacted to the data, confirming the view we noted yesterday that the currency may be more linked to developments surrounding the broader market sentiment for now. After all, we believe that the hawkish Bank of England may already be priced in. Now, from the Eurozone, we get the bloc's industrial production for August, and the forecast points to a 1.6% slide after a 1.5% increase in July. This is likely to take the year-over-year rate down to 4.7% from 7.7%. Now, with regards to the energy market, we have the American Petroleum Institute weekly report on crude oil inventories, but as it is always the case, no forecasts are available. As for the speakers, we will get to hear from Bank of England Deputy Governor for Financial Stability, John Cunliffe, and Fed Board Governor Lyle Brainard. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.